Ah! Greetings, I'm the Count Gore Duval, and welcome to Creature Feature, the weekly web program. This week, I bring you an Anglo-Italian film by the name of Lady Frankenstein. It stars American actor Joseph Cotten, who was picking up a few extra bucks while he was in retirement. It was directed by Mel Wells, who is better known as the shopkeeper in Little Shop of Horrors. And it is liberally sprinkled with naked women throughout the film. I wonder, could you have it conservatively sprinkled? Nah, I don't think so. Anyway, all that aside, let's see. Oh, I really do like this film. I really do. It has a lot of naked women, yes. But that aside, I'm afraid I may not be able to watch it with you. Why? Because we had to schedule an appointment with a representative of big government, someone from the Planning Commission coming by to talk about the new addition that we're putting on to the castle. But I'm hoping that I can. There's the gong. Come in! May I help you?
Hi, my name is Cassandra Lynn with the Planning Commission, and I take it you are Mr. Duval.
That's Count Duval, Count Gore Duval, but you can just call me Gore.
I see that you're planning an addition. May I ask what the
structure is? We're going to build a blood bank.
A bank? So this will be a commercial structure?
Not really. It's a private blood bank where the public can come in and make deposits, but only I can make withdrawals. But I understand you have a process here and you have a lot to do here. I don't want to hold you up, but
yes.
We're in the middle of something right now, and I just need to know how long this is going to take.
Well, it depends. I have to inspect everything, including the junk.
What? You have to inspect my junk?
Yes, extensively.
This may take a while. Let's get on with our movie tonight. Lady Frankenstein on Creature Feature, the weekly web program. I've got junk like you've never seen. I hope you had a good Halloween. I know some of you do suffer from PTHD. You know, that's post-traumatic Halloween depression. Yeah, you know, it's a full year until the next one. And frankly, I suffered from it too. I mean, what do we got looking forward to? I mean, the next holiday is what? Thanksgiving? I mean, it's not a big vampire day. Although it does bring up the question, what does a vampire pour on his Thanksgiving turkey? Ah. Grave. E. Anyway, and then after that, the next thing up is Christmas. It's a vampire. It's a holiday that every vampire should stay far away from. And then after that, it's New Year's and a long, cold, dark winter with the emphasis on cold. Ooh. Of course, that also brings up the question, what would you get if you crossed a snowman with a vampire? Frostbite.
Well, you just lost your audience with that one.
Oh, there you are. I can't believe it. This storm is like a giant snow beast trying to bury everything in its sight. It's at times like this that I want to send a very important message to all our fans and viewers north of the border in Canada. I like Canada. I love Canadians. I mean, Canada is the home of Rue Morgue magazine, so I know you guys love and appreciate horror. But I have only one request of you, okay? And that is, Keep your cold and snow north of the border, will you please? I know I had enough of this down here right now. Let's get back to our movie, Snow Beast.
I got an IM from a woman. She says, Concord Duval, my husband won't leave his computer. He's afraid someone might turn it on.
Kill the power! I can't take it any longer!
So, you know, that's what... Let's change the subject entirely, okay? I was at the recent horror convention, you know, and I got to meet lots of people. And I walk up to this woman and I said, you know, drinking really makes you look beautiful. And she looked at me and says, but Gore, I haven't been drinking. I said, I know, but I have. And you know, this show comes to you from the nation's capital, Washington, D.C., the home of politicians. And you know, politicians are a lot like contraceptives. They give you a feeling of security about your being screwed. With that note, I want one last comment from Frank and Bess. Frank and Bess, would you sum up tonight's movie, Manos, Hands of Fate?
Hasta la vista, baby.
I agree entirely. Hasta la vista, luego, or may all your blood be warm. It's going to be better next time. It will, it will. I'm going to go find a better film, okay? Bye.
You like it? It's yours.